Welcome to Atlanta, where the roof is closed and the Steel Falcon is soaring in place as the 1-1 Portland Riverhawks come into Mercedes-Benz Stadium and look to take down the also 1-1 Atlanta Falcons in some interconference action. 3rd-and-1 on the Riverhawks opening drive, and where they frequently failed last week, they convert here as Leighton Rasby picks up 12 yards to move the chains. 2 plays later, 2nd-and-15, where Mahomes looks to throw, escaping the pocket to his right, making a dangerous throw that finds Long Winborn. He's got room and takes this one for 24 yards near midfield. Riverhawks across midfield, and on 2nd-and-2, it's Leighton Rasby again picking up the first as he gains 9 to the Falcon 37. Then facing a 3rd-and-6, Mahomes throwing and wants Long Winborn again, but is well off the mark, incomplete, bringing up 4th down, and Harrison Butker from 50 yards out puts the kick right down the middle into the net, and Portland jumps out to the early 3-0 lead. First play of the ensuing drive, and Atlanta comes punching right back as Devontae Freeman spins away from Walker McDonald, breaks away from Ken Crawley, and hits the open field before finally being knocked out of bounds after a 36-yard run into Portland territory. Then on the following play, the Portland defense delivers a counterpunch as Anthony Hitchens and Dorian O'Daniel tag team Matt Ryan for a sack and a huge loss of 14, putting Atlanta right back on their side of the field. And on 3rd-and-22, Matt Ryan play fakes and is going to fire over the middle to Julio Jones for 16 yards to get Atlanta back into field goal range, where 45-year-old Matt Bryant comes on and knocks through the 52-yard field goal sponsored by AARP, and the Falcons tie this one at 3. Atlanta back with the ball, and on 3rd-and-5, Matt Ryan finds a diving Mohamed Sanu for 12 yards to move the chains. Then on the next play, Ryan with the play fake and going deep down the middle, where Calvin Ridley makes the catch, gets blasted by Eric Berry, ball comes out, Portland's there to dive on it, and the Riverhawks take over at their own 32-yard line, and Calvin Ridley, you got
jacked up!
2 plays later, and the Riverhawks move the chains as Hamid Heyman takes it right up the middle and right to midfield for 11 yards in the first. Then to end the first quarter, Mahomes dropping to throw and floats to a wide-open Travis Kelce, who picks up 18 more down to the Atlanta 27. Griffin Murphy loves it and starts trying to uppercut Riverhawk backups. So 2nd quarter now, and on 3rd-and-6, the Falcons defense holds again as Mahomes stands in and is dropped for the sack by Vic Beasley. Harrison Butker is sent out again and is good for a 2nd time, this time from 44 yards out, and Portland once again takes a 3-point lead. First play of the ensuing drive, and again the Falcons come firing back as Ryan play fakes and throws a dot to Julio Jones for 24 yards just shy of midfield. Next play, and it's 20 more Falcon yards as Ryan fires a rocket down the seam to Mohamed Sanu. Next play again, and keep those chains moving as Devontae Freeman takes it right up the middle and inside the 20 for 13 more yards. Then facing a 3rd-and-6, Ryan looking to throw and fires for the end zone, where Austin Hooper makes the catch, keeping both feet in bounds for the score, and the 14-yard touchdown gives the Falcons a 4-point lead at 10-6. Portland trying to answer back, and on their first play, Hamid Heyman moves the chains with an 11-yard carry to start the drive. 3 plays later, 3rd-and-8, where Mahomes goes to Travis Kelce over the middle and across midfield, picking up 17 and the 1st down. Riverhawks with another 3rd down, where Mahomes throws quick to Hamid Heyman, and the 7-yard catch moves the chains again. Next play, and this time it's Heyman picking up the 1st down on the ground as he gains 13 yards down to the 11. Then on 3rd-and-5 from the 6, Mahomes throwing, steps up and dumps off to Hamid Heyman, who's wearing cement blocks on his feet and can't move an inch. So once again, the Riverhawks can't score a touchdown, settling for a 23-yard field goal, which cuts the Falcon lead to 1. Falcons looking to extend that lead before half, and Ryan fires over the middle to a wide-open Julio Jones for 15 yards across midfield. But 3 plays later, Falcons still at the 45, facing a 3rd-and-10, where Ryan looking to throw, tries to escape the pocket, but Steven Nelson drops him for the sack, which would send us into the break. Then less than a minute into the 2nd half, Mahomes looking to throw to Sammy Watkins, but holy inaccuracy, Batman, as he throws it right to Deion Jones for the interception. And 43 seconds into the 3rd quarter, the Falcons take possession at the Riverhawk 37. 4 plays later, Matt Ryan throwing and goes over the middle to Austin Hooper for 16 yards down to the 5 to set up 1st-and-goal. And 2 plays later, Devontae Freeman caps off the drive by bouncing off Riverhawks and burrowing his way into the end zone, and the 1-yard score to start the 2nd half extends their lead to 8. Portland still looking to find the end zone, and on their first play, it's Mahomes to Tyreek Hill for 15 yards and a 1st down to start the drive. 2 plays later, 2nd-and-7, and Mahomes able to not throw a horribly inaccurate pass to Sammy Watkins, this time as he finds him for the 1st down across midfield. 2 plays later, again, Mahomes with the play fake, and by God, it's the fumble animation of Doom's music. Portland somehow gets it back, and on 3rd-and-19, Mahomes stands in and throws one deep for Sammy Watkins, where it bounces off his hands and is caught. Watkins takes it in for the 58-yard score, and Portland cuts the Falcon lead back to 1. Portland with a chance at a three and out, but on third and three, Ryan with all day to throw and eventually finds Austin Hooper coming back to the ball for an 18-yard gain. Three plays later, third down again, where it's more of the same as Ryan has all day to throw before going to Austin Hooper again, who does a f***ing Michael Jackson moonwalk to stay in bounds for the catch. Then facing another third down, Ryan throwing again and going for Calvin Ridley, but Kendall Fuller gets his hand in to knock it away incomplete. Matt Bryant comes on to put through his second field goal, this one brought to us by Depends Adult Diapers, and Atlanta now leads by four. Falcons get it right back, but on their first play, Ryan play fakes and rolls to his right, where he finds 311 pounds of rookie Frank Norman, who gets his first career sack and says, "Are you not entertained?" And two plays later, the Atlanta faithful would be entertained as the Falcons convert a third and 17 on the Ryan to Jones 25-yard connection. Fourth quarter now, Falcons across midfield facing third and three, where Ryan fakes and goes short to the fullback, who they say makes the catch but ends up losing two, so Atlanta forced to punt it away. Portland facing a third down of their own, where Hamid Heyman picks up five and a new set of downs. Then facing third down again, Mahomes throwing and delivers to Travis Kelce over the middle for 20 yards into Atlanta territory. But on third and 12, this time the luck runs out as Mahomes' pass is knocked down at the line. So out comes Harrison Butker, and from 56 yards, his kick is good and cuts the deficit back to one. So back to the Falcon offense, where on second down, Ryan play fakes and finds a wide open Austin Hooper for 22 yards near midfield. Then two plays later, Ryan throwing again for Hooper and is nearly picked off by Ken Crawley as it bounces right off his hands. Griffin Murphy says, "Good play, Ken, but now you owe us one." And so does Matt Ryan, apparently, as he throws again, and this time he is picked off as Xavien Howard makes the huge play for the Portland defense. And with 7:46 to go, the Riverhawks take over near midfield. Three plays later, facing a third and four, Mahomes throwing and drifting to his right before firing a rocket to Hamid Heyman, who makes the catch for 23 yards to the Falcon 32. Two plays later, second and five, and the chains move again as Leighton Rasby carries up the middle for nine more. Two plays later again, Falcons bring the blitz, but Mahomes fires quick over the middle to Travis Kelce, who walks into the end zone for the score. And after trailing most of the day, Portland takes the lead with 3:55 left on the clock. First play of the ensuing drive, and it takes Atlanta one play to enter Portland territory as Ryan hits Calvin Ridley for 27 yards as he slides out of bounds. Then two plays later, Ryan throwing again and floats a dangerous pass down the seam that's nearly intercepted by Jatavius Spearman. So make it third and 10, where Ryan's throwing again but nowhere to go, tries to run but only gets back to the line, and with three timeouts, the Falcons elect to punt. And on Portland's second play, they're able to move the chains as Hamid Heyman has a huge hole, picking up 11 yards and a new set of downs as we tick down to the 2-minute warning, but Atlanta still with those three timeouts. And after using them on first and second, the Riverhawks choose to throw on third, where Mahomes finds Travis Kelce but shy of the marker. Falcons use their last timeout and their offense will get it back. Second play of the drive, Ryan looking to throw and floats one towards the sideline for Calvin Ridley, but Steven Nelson with the tight coverage and it falls incomplete to make it third and 10. And on that third down, Ryan looking to throw behind great protection and again floats one towards the sideline, and it's once again nearly picked off by Ken Crawley. So make it fourth down, and with the game on the line, Ryan goes to his favorite target and finds a wide open Julio Jones for 29 yards into Portland territory. Atlanta rushing to the line, and on the next play, the sticks move again as Ryan finds Devontae Freeman for 11 more yards down to the Riverhawk 27-yard line. And the hurry up continues as Ryan looks to throw again, and the Falcons get another 11 yards on the completion to Mohamed Sanu. Then two plays later, Ryan fires down the seam to a wide open Ray Waller for the 16-yard score. And after having a fourth down at their own 32, the Falcons go 68 yards and now only need the extra point to tie. And Matt Bryan is able to knock it through, and with 36 seconds to go, we're tied at 27. But Portland not settling for overtime, and on their second play, it's Mahomes with a rocket to Tyreek Hill for 19 yards near midfield. Portland uses their first timeout. Next play, and Mahomes throwing again, this time to Sammy Watkins, who drags the defender right to the edge of field goal range to the Atlanta 39, and Portland uses their second timeout. And with 16 seconds to go, Mahomes throwing stands in and finds Tyreek Hill over the middle for 14 yards, and Portland well within field goal range now at the Atlanta 25. Riverhawks call timeout with 3 seconds to go, where Georgia Tech alum Harrison Butker's 42-yard field goal is right down the middle, and the Portland Riverhawks with more fourth quarter magic earn their second win of the season in the final seconds. Patrick Mahomes goes for over 300 yards and throws 2 touchdown passes, one to Sammy Watkins and one to Travis Kelce, who both come up just shy of 100-yard days. Matt Ryan throws for almost 400 yards, but not enough, and the Falcons will look look to get back in the win column next week as they head to New Orleans. Meanwhile, the Riverhogs stay down south as they head to Tampa Bay next week to take on the Buccaneers. All right, guys, so another really good game there that comes down to the final seconds, just like our opener, and that really was very similar to the first game we played against the Broncos. I still have yet to score a touchdown in the first half, but again, we're able to make the plays late and get the job done. I don't know if it's just been adjusting to the new playbook or what, but something has just felt kind of off offensively in my first few games, so it'll be interesting to see how things work out moving forward. But with week three, we start to get into scouting and negotiations, and starting here with the negotiations, we were able to lock up the defending league MVP with relative ease, signing him to a 5-year, $165 million contract, with 65 of that being guaranteed, which comes out to $33 million per year. He was asking for $140 million over 5 years, but I decided to reward him for being the MVP and bump that up quite a bit. And then moving along, our second negotiation was with Travis Kelce, and I decided to table contract talks with him, and what that means is we'll just be coming back to them later. I'll probably end up doing the same thing with Sammy Watkins when his come up in a couple weeks, because I'm probably going to sign one of these guys, but almost certainly not both, so I want to see how the year plays out and how they perform over the course of the season before I make a decision. Moving on to scouting, we had one draft story that popped up at the beginning of the year, and you can ignore all the others there from last season, but the draft story we do have is titled From the Dojo to the Gridiron and reads, Tyler Lamar is hoping his skill as a martial arts star translates to the football field as he's joined the Texas squad at cornerback. So looking at the draft board, we start with Tyler Lamar at the top, who carries a B-plus man coverage and B-press grade. Below him are two more corners in Gerard Burns and Jaquan Black, and this actually appears to be a pretty strong corner draft, which hasn't been the case in the first two seasons. But then below the corners, we have a pair of outside linebackers, one on the right in Martinez Perry and one on the left in Morgan Hull, that both don't look too bad. But that covers the team side of things, which means we move to the league, where week three kicked off with the Bears taking down their division foe in the Vikings 21-19. Moving to Sunday, the Eagles beat the Ravens 27-21 in overtime. Cowboys take down the Browns 28-25. Bills also go to overtime and hand the Patriots their first loss. Bengals drop the Colts. Steelers win a 14-7 game over the Texans. Dolphins beat the Jets 31-21. Jaguars bounce back from their beatdown last week to beat the Titans. Cardinals easily handle the 49ers 24-3. Buccaneers beat their old division rival 28-21. Chargers drop the Raiders to move to 3-0. Rams beat Julian Casa and the Giants 28-20. Panthers destroy the Broncos, dropping them to 0-3. And then on Sunday night, the Saints win a close one 17-14 over the Lions. And on Monday night, the Redskins pick up a 31-14 win over the Seahawks. So looking at the standings, starting in the AFC, where the Dolphins pull even with the Patriots at the top of the East, and they both hold a one-game lead over the Jets and Bills. Steelers off to a 3-0 start, lead the North with the Bengals one game back. In the South, the Jaguars and Titans are tied at the top at 2-1. And then in our division, the Chargers are 3-0, but we're only a game back at 2-1. Moving to the NFC, the Redskins move to 3-0 and hold sole possession of the division lead in the East. Packers are 2-1 and hold a one-game lead over the Lions, Bears, and Vikings. Saints and Panthers are tied at 2-1 and are a game up on the Bucks and Falcons. And then, as has been the case in the first two seasons, the Rams are off to an early head start in the West, as they already have a two-game lead over the rest of their division. The Week 3 AFC Offensive Player of the Week is wide receiver Rishard Matthews of the Titans. The ninth-year receiver out of Nevada had 6 catches for 123 yards and accounted for all three of his team's scores in the Titans' 24-21 loss to Jacksonville this week. On the NFC side, the quarterback we faced last week takes home the award in Cam Newton of the Panthers. The former number one overall pick completed 75% of his passes for 273 yards and 4 touchdowns as the Panthers tore apart the Broncos 44-18 in Carolina. Defensively, the AFC award goes to Tony Jefferson of the Baltimore Ravens. Jefferson was in on 13 tackles, with 10 of them being solo and 1 for a loss. Jefferson also defensed one pass and picked off another, but was on the losing side of a 27-21 game in Philadelphia. As for the NFC, the award goes to first-time winner Akello Witherspoon of the 49ers. The 79 overall cornerback from Colorado made 12 tackles and also picked off a pass in Arizona, but the 49er offense couldn't do anything, and San Francisco lost 24-3 to the Cardinals. So from players of the week to league leaders, where we start with the passers, and Jared Goff takes the top spot in passer rating with his 133.2 mark, and then Baker Mayfield leads the league in both passing yards and touchdowns. touchdowns with 993 yards passing and 10 passing scores. Moving to the rushers, Le'Veon Bell leads the way in rushing yards with 384 and touchdowns with 5. And then once again, Royce Freeman keeps the top spot in yards per carry, but is now down to a 6.2 average. When it comes to the receivers, Odell Beckham Jr. leads the way in both receptions with 23 and receiving yards with 343. And then AFC Offensive Player of the Week, Rishard Matthews, leads the way in touchdown catches with 5. And then lastly, for the defensive leaders, Devondre Campbell takes over as the tackle leader with 29. Aaron Donald holds the top spot in sacks with 4. And then Raiders rookie Vincent Haynes, who was the stud corner they drafted, is tied for the league lead in picks with 2. And as we wrap up, we always take a look at the week's upcoming schedule, and things start with a matchup between 1-2 teams as the Eagles head to Levi's Stadium to face the 49ers on Thursday night. Moving to Sunday, the Seahawks stay on the East Coast as they play the Giants in New York after playing the Redskins in Washington last week. Cardinals, Bills, and Packers, Vikings. We head across the United States to play the Buccaneers. Chargers at Panthers, Browns at Bengals, and Raiders at Steelers. Patriots and Scott Cleveland with a chance to make a statement in LA against the Rams. Jets at Broncos, Falcons at Saints, and Colts at Titans. Then on Sunday night, the Jaguars head to Houston to face the 0-3 Texans. And on Monday night, more divisional action as the Lions head to Chicago to face the Bears in a huge game for both teams. And Baltimore, Dallas, Miami, and Washington are the first teams to have a bye week. But that's going to do it for week 3. We pick up a nail-biting win over the Falcons, and while we do move to 2-1, we're also very close to possibly being 0-3. But ask any Madden player, any real Madden player, whether you win by an inch or a mile, winning's winning. And next game, we head to Tampa Bay to take on the Buccaneers and try to move to 3-1. Hope you guys enjoyed the highlights, commentary, and around the league news. And until next time, thanks for watching.